That's groovy.
You're tuned to Radio Caroline.
Life aboard the ocean and radio waves certainly has its attractions despite postmaster generals. It was a postmaster general, Mr. Reginald Bevins, under the last Conservative government, who made the prediction that if the government didn't act against pot pirates, the coasts of Britain would soon be ringed by an armada of pot pirate ships. Well, it looks as if the pot pirates will be left alone and are making money.
Guys and gals, everyone's
in the there's something special on my mind. Last night I met a new girl in the neighborhood. Whoa, yeah. Something tells me I'm into something good.
Hello there. Let me take you back to 1964. It's Easter. And kids all around the Essex coastline are swinging around in their radio tuners. So they've got the home service and the light program. But suddenly, on a strange frequency, comes a strange sound. It's the sound of Radio Caroline. Well, 30 years later, people are still remembering that event. And they're remembering, in fact, not only the event of the station starting up, but also the demise of the stations with the Offshore Broadcasting Act. But this here is a model of Radio Caroline, not the one that I used to listen to back in 64. This is Radio Caroline Mark III, and we'll find out a little bit more about it in a few moments. Well, with me is Albert Hood. Albert, you're the organiser of today's Radio Caroline get-together. So you've actually got the Ross Revenge, one of the ships of Brookhouse Radio Caroline, in your hot little hands, haven't you?
That's right, yes.
How did you get hold of the ship?
Well, when it was shipwrecked on the Goodwin Sands, if I dare say shipwrecked, it wasn't actually wrecked, but when it went on the Goodwin Sands, our good friends at Dover Harbour went and got it into Dover for us, charged us an extortionate fee to do it, but we paid them, and then theoretically, it belongs to a group of sort of people that raise money now to try and get it back shipshape, if that's the quiet word, which is what we're doing at the moment. Yeah, that's
it. What did the advent of pirate broadcasting mean to you?
Something different, something new, something that we'd never heard in this country before up until 64, with the exception of Radio Luxembourg. Mm. And when Caroline came along and the rest of the pirates, of course, it was just like a new era, you know, something new, you know, nobody heard it before. And, you know, we're trying to keep it that way.
But I mean, I used to pick Caroline upon the...
Well, here we are, we're on board the tender, and we're just about to go out to sea, the Ross Revenge, and this is where we get our sea links. I know this is a thing that says life jackets available on request, and there's a lifeboat just come in, and I'm a bit worried, but never mind, I'm British, I'll survive. Well, this is something I've always wanted to do because we're now on board the Ross Revenge. This is the studio of Radio Caroline, so if you'll excuse me, let me give you a call sign. From the MV Ross Revenge, this is Radio Caroline. Or if you want to be more accurate, it says at the bottom, from the Blackwater Estuary in Essex, this is Radio Caroline. At present, our location is 51 degrees 44 north, 0 degrees 52 degrees east. And this is a studio from which a lot of those great programmes came from back in the, up to about 1990s. Still two studios here, both operational still. One had the Dutch service in it. The other, I'm told, had the English language service. And looking around at this gear, well, quite a lot of gear which is awfully familiar to anybody who works in the industry. The other heart of the system, of course, is the mixer. This mixes the record turntables, the cassette turntables, the CD, and just behind us, the two tape machines. So all the machines here are ganged through the mixer. And you could sit here and play records to your heart's content, you know. It's a great experience being on board the Ross Revenge. So if you'll just excuse me, let me give you a better station on-air check and our location.
Hello and happy Easter to all of you. This is Christopher Moore with the first record program on Radio Caroline. The first record is by the Rolling Stones, and I'd like to play it for all of the people who worked to put the station on the air, and particularly for Ronan.
I can't get no satisfaction.
That's groovy.
You're tuned to Radio Caroline on 199, your all-day music station.
How long have you been on board yourself?
Long time, long time. How long have I been on board? Six weeks.
It seems to me, and I'm not being unkind, you could do with a rest.
Yes, I could do with a rest.
But anyway, a little bit neurotic, are you?
Well, a little bit, yes. You know, I'm smoking about 60 of these things a day. But it's, you know, it's all happening. It's great to be in the middle of it all.
What don't you like about it?
Don't I like about it? I don't like not getting enough sleep, but apart from that, fine.
This is Caroline South on 259 meters in the medium wave band, the continuing sound of free radio, now the one and only, and your future in commercial radio.
Is a story of man's fight for freedom. The beginning is in the past, the middle is now, the end is in the future. It is a story of sadness and of triumph. August the 14th, as disc jockeys Robbie Dale, Johnny Walker and Ross Brown leave Liverpool Street, London, spurred on toward the sea by the hundreds of cheering people. See them now as they stand on the tender. There are tears in their eyes as their families, their homes, and their loved ones are left behind. 3 o'clock on this Monday afternoon, and on 266, Big Lil is heard for the last time. Caroline is alone. These three men prepare for midnight. For in a few hours' time, they are to challenge the might and the power of the British government. They will become criminals. Midnight approaches. It is August the 15th. Johnny Walker announces that Caroline belongs to you, that she loves you and she will continue. The Beatles sing All You Need Is Love. These two men sound happy, but underneath they are sad, for they now know that they have passed the point of no return. They are not sad for long. They are joined by other men who also gave up so much to fight for freedom. The seas are rough and cruel, life is hard, but as each day passes, the moment of triumph grows nearer. The British people rally round. They send food, they send comfort, and they send their love. All you need is love, and love overcomes. The British government relents. Caroline raises her anchor and heads for England. See her now majestically and proudly sailing up the river toward the capital that has welcomed so many victors in British history. But none as victorious as these men. They stand on the deck waving to the millions of people who line the Thames. This time the tears flooding from their eyes are tears of happiness. The insurmountable odds have been surmounted. They reunite with their families, with their friends, with their loved ones. We are near the end of our story. London's skyline has a new landmark pointed toward the heavens. Caroline's aerial. At last, beaming out its love and music to a free and peaceful nation. We have overcome. The battle is over. Free radio becomes a way of life, but never taken for granted. For no man will ever forget Monday, August the 14th, 1967.